Oh, Heading to the Elrod is nearby just around the corner.
There is a blown up plastic toy. It looks like a pig.
That's a blow up toy.
And I feel like that officer has a camera as well. Possibly. I'm not sure. It's hard to tell. Because there's a light behind the officer, so it's hard to see. It's one officer.
I'm here again, right?
Yeah.
So what we can do?
Yeah.
I was outside of my patio, so that's a.
Yeah.
Yeah. A lot of.
Black, 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 black Patrick Dillon!
See, he was, that officer is watching me in Tag Life. I knew it. He went up to a couple other officers and pointed me out to them, and he's just following me, watching me. The sign for the light just went off as we were looking at it there. The light for the sign, pardon me. Light for the sign. All right. this sort of happened again today, so.
Life leads that way sometimes.
Apparently, that's the thing,
yeah.
I was told.
Yeah.
I was on the other side, and this officer here leaned against the pole, because I'm already really hard. I took a bunch of pictures, and then I ended up, he talked to two other people, sending me out, it felt like, it was a joke. It's like, him over here, and he's just been staring me down hard.
Okay.
Yeah, I'm not sure who he is.
More accurate
than I was talking about. Are you downtown,
right?
Yeah. How is it down there?
A lot more subdued.
Yeah. So everyone that's here, we have someone that has arrived at this protest. Why don't you introduce yourself?
My name is Gregory Joey Johnson. I was a defendant many years ago in the U.S. Supreme Court flag burning case called Texas versus Johnson. And I was the person that fought for people to have the right to burn the American flag in protest if that's what they want to do. And it was a hard fight. This government has never accepted a decision in my case. They constantly tried to recriminalize it. I've been arrested multiple times. When I have a Supreme Court decision that says it's my right to do it. And I burn the flag because it's a symbol of international oppression and plunder and murder, of invasions, occupations, torture, coup d'etats, mass starvation, slavery, genocide of the Native Americans, all of
that. So what was it about these protests that brought you out here to Portland?
Just getting to that, I definitely wanted to come up here when I heard what was going on, the resilience of the people here in Portland standing up against federal pigs being dispatched to Portland, and the abductions, the brother that was scooped up off the street, the brother getting shot in the head with a beanbag round, it's just hideous. And but more, there was a defiance of the people standing up against it. When I was working to come up here, we had been 50 plus days already. And I wanted to stand with y'all and come in and express my support and to learn from what you all are doing, because the kind of resilience that's going on here in Portland needs to be going on all over the country. There might need to be millions of people out in the streets driving this fascist regime of Trump and Pence from power, you know, who's doing mass defiance, saying we're not going to stop until the regime is gone.
Do you normally go out to places and join protests?
Yeah, this is what I've been doing my whole life since I was 18 years old. I've been fighting the power. I'm part of the movement for an actual revolution in LA, the Revolution Club. We're building a movement for an actual revolution, because none of this shit is going to end. The white supremacy that's so poured into the foundations of this country and all throughout its history, it ain't going to stop until the whole goddamn system of capitalism and imperialism is overthrown. And there's a strategy for that revolution, the work that Baba Bacon has been doing, the revolutionary leader Baba Bacon has been doing, and people need to find out about it. You know, take the effort to find it, because the thousands of us that are getting organized today, it's got to be part of bleeding millions when millions of people would rather lay down their lives and live one more day under this fucking system. The wars for empire, the patriarchal oppression of women, the repression of immigrants, the demonization of immigrants, the destruction of the global environment, and yeah, the genocidal persecution of black and brown people, the mass incarceration, the police terror, it's all systemic. Every one of those things come from is a requirement of this system to function. It can't be reformed away. They can't be voted away. It's got to be forcibly overthrown. And it's going to require millions of people to do that. And I know I'm out here tonight, and there's a lot of people that are like more anarchists, and I'm revolutionary communist. And I think we got to strive to have not be divisive with each other, but to have sensible struggle and discussion over what is it going to take to get humanity free. You know, that's a big question. And not be going off on each other, because this system's got a concentration camp for all of us together.
Do you see this movement as being able to make a change in the system?
I think what's gotta happen is two things. I think one, If this fascist regime of Trump and Pence consolidates power, it's going to be fucking immeasurably more difficult to do anything. Whether you believe in reform, which I don't, or you believe in revolution, which I do, but in either event, it's going to be immeasurably more fucking difficult. So the first step is to drive it, to drive the regime from power. And then we got to go on and do the work to prepare for an actual revolutionary situation, to take power. And we have a vision for a constitution for a new socialist republic in North America. And it, people can get it at revcom.us and examine it, study it, debate it.
You find out more about what you're doing.
Find out more about what we're doing, yeah.
If they're interested. All right. Well, thank you very much.
Yeah, it's good to be here with y'all. This whole week has been very moving and inspiring. And it's a different experience than in Los Angeles. It's different. And I'm very appreciative of it.
Awesome.
Good to talk with you.
Thank you very much. That was Gregory Joey Johnson, right?
That's right.
That's right.
Texas versus Johnson.
Let me
just add this. It's another right that they're trying to take away, the right to protest. And that's another reason I wanted to come up here, because when Trump gave his Juneteenth speech on June 20th, his white supremacist speech in Tulsa, Oklahoma, he talked about the statue of George Washington here in Portland that got pulled down with the American flag wrapped around its head, and then the flag set on fire. And he was using that to say that flag burning should once again be recriminalized. You know, that's what he's calling for. He wants the Supreme Court to overturn the decision in my case. So they're sending federal agents out here to Portland to smash heads and to militarize these rapid deployment pigs. They're trying to do this all over the country, trying to criminalize protests, and they're also dispatching them in cities like Chicago and Kansas City to go after the people on the bottom of society, the black and brown people in the inner cities.
Thank you. That was a lot of information. So,
well, hopefully it's helpful.
Hopefully it's helpful.
I'm glad we were finally able to connect.
Right. Yeah, I wasn't downtown for too long.
That's all right.
The other day. So
it's chaotic times.
You're right.
You had a very legitimate excuse to be absent from class.
Well, there's a lot going on here in Portland.
Absolutely.
So I'm going to make sure that I can cover you, if you don't mind.
All right. Good talking to
you. Thank you.
You take care.
That was Joey Johnson. He's in the Texas versus Johnson Supreme Court case. That was about the burning of the U.S. flag as protected under First Amendment speech. So I just want to show. There's a line here. People are just standing and chanting and squeaking things at the officers. I see a light. There are more officers walking around in the parking lot. Well, just kind of hard to see on the live stream, but there are officers back there as well. So there are more than you see. When the group was here on Saturday, there were also officers stationed in the roof around the building before the LRAD showed up. And the white cops came and pushed everyone down the road.
Oh man, I'm pretty quick on the planning and that's been a thing for a couple of weeks.
Yeah. Definitely part of the tax.
We don't need that.
I mean,
not like usually. They got
was that blow up
thing.
That is a blow up toy.
Same old thing.
That's a blow up toy. And protest it. That's just mother gonna do like kind of
self-employed?
I mean, I'm honestly surprised that they made an announcement with just that object.
That was
that. Yeah, that has been out here for quite some time. I've been live streaming and it's been out here when I was on the other side for a while.
Yeah.
Yeah, when we first arrived, the whole crowd and everybody arrived here.
I think so. I know. I heard it. I was like, all right.
Quit your job. Quit your job. Quit your job. Did you kill Patrick Kimmon? 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 Kendra James! Kendra James! Did you kill Kendra James? 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 One of these people killed Kendra James. One of these people killed Kendra James. Are these people still work here? Are you laughing at that? Are you laughing at the death of a person? Are you laughing at the death of a person that one of your coworkers may have? Did you kill 20 days? Did you kill 20 days? Did you kill 20 days? Did you take his life? Did you take 20 days' life? Did you take 20 days life? What about Kendra James? You flinch when I say Kendra James. Did you kill Kendra James? Did you kill Kendra James? Why do you flinch when I say Kendra James? Why do you flinch when I say Kendra James? Kendra James! Kendra James! Did you kill Kendra James? Did you kill Kendra James? Did you kill Kendra James? Did you? Did you? Did you? You just nodded your head! You killed Kendra James? You killed Kendra James? You killed Kendra James? You just nodded your head. You killed Kendra James? If you personally didn't do it, you have blood on your hands anyway. If you work here, you killed Kendra James. If you work here, you killed Kendra James. If you work here, you killed Bonnie Page. If you work here, you killed Pete Notice. You killed Pete Notice. You killed Kendra James. You killed Bonnie Page. If you work here, you killed Kendra James. If you work here, you
don't get off the racist system. Thank you.
No, that's he's legitimate. I promise. Real fast. Yeah. No, he's legitimate.
No prison! Total abolition! No cops! No prison!
Total abolition!
No cops! No prison!
Total abolition!
No cops! No prison!
Total abolition!
No cops! No prison!
Total abolition!
No cops! No prison!
Total abolition!
No cops! No prison!
Hold your jaw.
job. Get your job. Get your job.
Get your job.
Get your fucking job.
The entire city fucking hates you.
Fucking wife. The same way you beat on us. Because you have a punk ass mentality. Hurt those who can't fight you. You guys are nothing but a bunch of punk ass bitches. We will protest until you meet our demand. And until you stop beating your wife and beating us.
8 minutes and 46 seconds. How about that?
I told you that you are here. You know, for this part, I put a book.
I just saw an officer walk back behind the tree line over there, keeping an eye in the parking lot. Standing here chanting and speaking spooky voice right now.
If, no. Yeah. But also, you don't know. No.
Off of standing around at the moment. Standing around the standoff?
Only the protesters brought drums inside. And a lot of squeaky toys, apparently. I've just been hearing loads of these little squeaky things.
I saw one in there. Yeah, these little
squeaky things.
Wait, are they just like adjacent or different?
I guess.
Officers are moving around and changing positions right now. Looks like there's another line. A new small line of officers running back there.
I tell my artist, I can't exactly guarantee my own safety at this juncture. Oh, there's a standoff for the drive off first.
So they brought down the American flag, it looks like. I just saw an officer has an American flag. They're removing the flag and the troopers are putting it somewhere. Here's some more officers coming up to reinforce their line. Switch off people and tag out. I don't know exactly what I'm saying yet. This is so weird.
We've been standing here so long.
I'm gonna try
your dog!
Personal break, and for my co-host, I will be back again live soon, and especially if anything happens. So.